Hello, hello, everybody. It is 9:22 p.m. Central Time on the 28th of November, 2020. It's still Saturday here in the United States since my last update. I've got some breaking news for everybody, and this is a pretty big deal, what I'm about to show you. So let's go over and show you what's going on. A new 50,000-foot high blast has occurred at Lewotolo Volcano in Indonesia. And this is the volcano that I talked about in my update just a few hours ago that we had never seen on the list the entire time that I've been live streaming, which is 5 years. And the last eruption on this volcano was 2012, or at least the last significant eruption. And we had never really heard about it. And I went and looked it up. Let me show you where it is. 50,000 foot high, flight level 500. And the location of the volcano is right here next to East Timor. Lewotolo Volcano. And we'll click on the Smithsonian. Anchoring the eastern end of an elongated peninsula that is connected to Lembata, formerly Lomblen, Island by a narrow isthmus and extends northward into the Flores Sea. Lewotolo rises 1,423 meters. It's a symmetrical stratovolcano, or I should say was, because it just blew so big. Let's get you a shot of it. This is a video from 39 minutes ago, and it's not that long of a video, 10-second long clip. Of course, it's coming from Indonesia. It's a wonder we even get anything out of here. But look, I mean, it's huge. This is the initial blast, 50,000 foot high. That's a big deal. And we have to reference where it is. So let's go over and show you on the plate boundary map. And we'll take it over into the West Pacific right here. Do you see where the red lines kind of branch out and come together? Or at least right back over to the east they come together, and then they branch out over to the west. Well, Lewotolo Volcano is right here where the two meet. And this follows a warning that I issued specifically for Indonesia next to Lewotolo Volcano. I had warned right here from Bali over to the east, right there. And then the new 50,000-foot-high blast has happened just over to the east of that, maybe 200 miles, 300 miles, something like that, over to the east. That is a big, significant eruption. It's likely going to make the news. I wouldn't be surprised if it already has made the news. We can go back over. I don't want to step on any copyrights or anything, play any other videos. You guys need to understand that this deep earthquake activity, the deep earthquakes that are raised high off the globe, I've been talking about this for the last few days. Well, it's no coincidence that we suddenly have a 50,000 foot high blast because the whole plate just shifted. Let me take you over here and show you what just shifted. The whole Indo-Australian plate, all the way around it, just shifted, and we talked about this being the center middle of it. And that's why I issued the warning for Indonesia. If you want to hear the warnings, they're over on my YouTube channel of all things. Let's jump over to YouTube and just show you where the warnings have been issued 2 days ago and 2 hours ago. And in that video 2 hours ago, I think I might even be able to fast forward it into the part where I'm talking about where to watch. Let's see if I can do that. Let's see, 5 minutes in, 6 minutes in, somewhere in that range, we're talking about the area around the central part of Indonesia. And then I pointed out right in there. I'm talking about it about 6 minutes into the video. I talk about the whole plate moving and the middle point being up by the new erupting Lewotolo volcano, which only had put off a 5 or 6,000 foot high blast. Now it's 50,000 foot high. It's extremely large. And luckily, at least as far as I know, there's no tsunami activity because this is on land. But that being said, you know what? Let's just go over and check the National Data Buoy Center and see what it shows. It might not show anything, but we might want to keep track on it just in case. They do have a few active buoys. They're not showing anything right now, but they're at least alive. So they do have nearby buoys. If there was to be any tsunami activity, it would be because of deformation from the large blast, but I don't think that's going to happen. I think it would need to be a little bit bigger. However, you see its proximity to the ocean. So it's quite literally just surrounded by seawater on three sides, and an isthmus connects it into the island. So it's pretty shocking when you get a 50,000 foot high blast in the middle of an area where you just issued a warning for a large earthquake or seismic release of some kind. And I don't forecast volcanic blasts, but with something like this, it's big enough that it's huge. It's a huge blast to take place. Now, seismically speaking, they're not reporting very much here nearby yet. So there's threes on all sides, but the volcano is right down here in the middle where all three sets of rings overlap for those three sets of threes. You know what? Maybe we should just jump back over to Twitter really quick and see if there's any other news on it. Again, I just want to see myself. Just curious. Lewotolo. Let's just search that. There's the earlier reports of just a little bit of activity. So that's the only one that's coming up right now. I wouldn't be surprised if maybe this is the only video of it. Let's go look at it on Google Earth one more time and just quickly take a look and see how rural it is around where the volcano is, because, you know, are there any cities around it of any kind? It looks like there's a few small villages. Like, look at the size of that village. A few hundred houses. And then there's some more down to the south. Again, same thing. Each village is a few hundred houses. Now we get down here and it looks like Lewotolo is more of a city. So if there's going to be video of it, it would probably be coming out of here. And the mileage on that, let's just see how far that is. Again, we're going 50,000 feet up in the air. And this is 10 miles away. So they should be able to see it all the way down here. I would think everybody in the whole region should be able to see it. It might even show up on our weather satellite, but not yet. Since it just happened 30 to 40 minutes ago, I would wait a few hours and then we'll check the weather satellite over the area and see if there's any kind of cloud cover that's blowing up from that. But with a 50,000 foot eye blast, they're going to have to issue warnings for pilots, which hence the FL500 warning here, flight level 500, 50,000 foot eye blast off of that. So let's just go ahead and check the location off the list. There will likely be seismic release in addition to this, but to get a big blast right in the middle, and again, let me show you right in the middle of what I'm talking about. This is the Indo-Australian plate. Australia, India. The red lines go around the whole outside edge, and the earthquakes match that over the last 48 hours. But let me back it out so you can see it. So around Australia, out to the Indian Ocean, back up across, going up into the Gulf of Aden by Saudi Arabia, then back across north of India, back down into Indonesia. And compare that, all those earthquakes, to this. Goes down around, back up and over, and back around. And this is the middle point, if you're to go to the middle point of the plate, between the plate. So between where the plates meet, that is the middle of it. And that's where the big blast just happened. If you're just now tuning in, a 50,000 foot high blast has occurred. And if what I mean by tuning in, by the way, if you're watching this on YouTube, you are watching a pre-recorded live event that's live right now over on Twitch. I'll put a link down below if you want to come over and watch. You can watch live 24/7 on Twitch. Keep this stream running as much as I can. Whenever I have an internet connection, the stream is on. And it shows the current earthquakes for the last 48 hours. And right here in the middle of the whole, as I said earlier, hot mess. In the middle of the whole hot mess, now the first 50,000 foot eye blast in many months' time for the whole planet. And it's centered right in the middle of everything that just happened, seismically speaking. Now there could be future seismic release next to the spot very soon in the next few days. When you get that kind of release, there's going to be some shifting that happens in the magma chamber. And the magma chamber is nestled into the side of the plate boundary. So I wouldn't be surprised if downstream or over to the west, we see new activity, and back behind it up to the east by northeast, following the red lines. But that gets into something entirely different. Forecasting, I'm not issuing a forecast now. I will be doing a forecast tomorrow, and that will include the West Pacific. One more time, 50,000 foot high blast right in the middle of the area that I warned in today's video over on YouTube. So, and that's been up for several hours now, so you guys can go watch it, and in there I talk about it, specifically the spot that just erupted. And I mentioned the volcano, Lewotolo, in the warning. All right, guys, anything else? There's only one other thing, not that significant, but still fairly noteworthy. 3.8 and a 3.0, both off the western coast of France. Threes rolling out across France, and then 3.7 out here at Iceland. So a 3.8, coast of France, 3.7, Iceland. It only took like a hair of a point of a step down, jumping out from Europe over to Iceland. But I don't think we're done yet. I think Italy will still move, but it's been hit. Actually, it's been hit on the plate boundary, but it's only a small quake. I'm still going to warn for the next couple days on that. Forecast out tomorrow, so tune back in tomorrow for that. If anything else significant happens, of course, I will jump back on at a moment's notice. 50,000 foot high blast. Wow. Man. Well, I mean, we knew we would be here. One more time, I mean, for those of you who have been watching my updates, you know when we start seeing deep earthquakes like this, you know to watch for shallower, larger activity. And right in the middle of all the deep earthquakes, that's where the new 50,000 foot high blast happened. I would imagine that the compression in these red line plate boundaries that I've been showing you, that it's major right there, the fulcrum point of it all, the middle point of it all. Something just displaced all of the Indo-Australian plate from India back around down through Indonesia, and a new blast just happened on the edge of it. One more time. You know what? Let me just show you one more time. I want you to understand again. All of this just moved with seismic activity all the way around it, and now the middle of it just blew. That's what's going on here. So it's kind of phenomenal to see it happen in real time. Glad you guys got to watch it with me. And like I said, one more time, if anything else significant happens, I will jump back on. I'm going to upload this now over on YouTube and play it back as a short premiere so that everybody around the world can understand what's going on. Because some people might not get the news. You might not know we're going through a huge amount of seismic unrest right now because of a deep earthquake event, solar activity bombarding the Earth, causing the deep earthquake event. And that the core of the Earth is vibrating. VLF, plasma core of the Earth, is vibrating and causing new deep earthquakes, which then cause shallower, larger earthquakes and volcanic blasts like what I'm talking about right now. It's something we have to pay attention to. When you start seeing the whole area around Australia to India move in a day, this is one day, 2 days at the most, 48 hours. Same with over here. You start seeing the area all the way around South America move in a 48-hour time period, and they both happen in the same time frame. That's major movement. So you've got to start watching for major seismic and major volcanic. Like I said, I don't forecast eruptions, but maybe I should start adding that into the mix on forecasting. Oh, this is not the first time that we've seen a huge blast right in the middle of a warned area where I issued the warning, and within a day, we're back on talking about the biggest blast in the whole year at the spot where the warning's been issued. This is like probably the fifth time, probably once a year, we're having this happen. It's happened at Mount Krakatoa, it's happened up at Kluchetskoy Volcano, or Bezimiani Volcano. Those are the two I can remember off the top of my head. Plus this, of course. That's three right there. Amazing stuff. I'll be back. Peace out.